Congrats, Coach, on a doubleheader sweep against Merrimack. Your thoughts on the team's performance?
Yeah, I thought it was an okay day. I mean, I think it's really difficult to beat a team four times. And I think there's things throughout the day that I felt like we needed to work on. But, you know, this is what this preseason is for. It's to figure out, you know, what we need to fine tune and what we need to go back to work on at practice. And, you know, any time that we win, I'm happy. Right. I think it's a great thing. And I felt like today gave us a little bit more insight into, you know, information we needed, obviously looking to prepare for conference.
And then looking at the lineup of both Emily Gann, Nicole Amodio, really saw the ball well today at the plate. What did you think of their two performances today?
Yeah, I mean, I think they stepped up huge. I mean, obviously for Nicole, I think Nicole had a standout four games. You know, I think it's one of those pieces where when you're hot, you know what I mean? It's nice. It's a really good feeling. And we have to do our part to kind of keep her in that position. But, you know, she drove in runs. She made things happen. And I think that's what we're expecting in that spot. You know, she was in the 5 or 6 hole this weekend. And to me, you know, people are going to get on ahead of her and she needs to do her part. But, you know, Nick is finding a way to be consistent and finding a way to be in the lineup. And I love that. Emily's scrappy. You know what I mean? I mean, she can hit a gap, but she also can and drop one down and beat it down the line. She can chop one and get on. So I think Emily is playing her game right now, which I think is awesome. So, you know, when she's a real triple threat, that's very hard to defend. You know, so I'm excited about where those two are at. And, you know, I'm hoping that can continue as we go forward with this thing.
Right. And then sometimes it's easy to forget the leadoff batter, but Caitlin Coker, she tied a program record with 4 walks in the first game and then had a clutch hit. In the second game, what'd you think of her performance?
I mean, I love on base percentage. So you can look at batting average all day, but I tell you what, like I look at that on base percentage after every single game. I want to know who's getting on base. I don't care how, but if we're on base, we can make something happen. You know, so for us, if you're walking, getting hit by pitch, I don't care how it happens, somehow get your butt to one. but you know what? I'm always satisfied with where Coker's at. I think Coker does a really great job of playing her game. And, you know, she is a legitimate offensive player. So I thought she played great defensively too. So, you know, it's little by little, our lineup, I think, is solidifying. And I tell you what, she owns that one spot.
And then we continue to talk about the depth that you have. And Allison Boas, she hits her first career homer and then adds a double. I mean, what does that say about that you have another bat that you can use throughout the season?
Yeah, I love it. I mean, I think right now, like we're trying to find our best lineup and you know, you have to look at the offensive things. You know, we have Allie Dubois on the mound, right? So I think with Allie, you know, we have a shot to win every single game. We got to be able to put up numbers, right? So for us, I mean, we're looking to see, you know, who can have quality at bats. And I'm not asking for, you know, home runs, doubles, hits, whatever. I'm just asking for good at bats. And I do think that we're kind of getting there. So little by little, people are stepping up and they're getting better and better at bats. I was happy for Allie today. Right. That's great. I think Allie Bowes is a great first baseman. I think that we're going to utilize her on the mound. So if she can add a stick in our lineup, that's going to be helpful.
And then what did you think of Emily Gann, Lizzie Avery? They kind of ran into a little bit of trouble, but what did you see from their pitches today?
Yeah, no, I think it was great for Gann. I think that she spun the ball well. I think that she got through the lineup once and, you know, we were going to mix it up as is. So I think going into the game, you know, Em's been working on some things, right? So, you know, she's, you know, battling some minor injuries and we just want to get her comfortable and get her to a good spot. So for her, she was going once through the lineup and obviously Avery got to come in. You know, Avery's got to find a way to throw a strike. She has all the potential in the world. She's incredibly talented, you know, so it's just a matter of how do we, you know, find a way to kind of calm our nerves out there and get it done. But I was really happy with Emily. And I think, you know, Avery had 2 walks, but she also got a soft ground ball that we should have made a play on. You know, so I think she could have actually lasted a lot longer if we had stepped up and made that play. But, you know, I switched over to Allie just for a momentum shift and, you know, to do our part to try to win this game.
Right. And then finally, you have a week to prepare for Boston College. What do you want to work on with the team?
Scotty, everything. Yeah, I mean, just go back to the drawing board. I think there were some base running things. There were some defensive things. Obviously, offense. I mean, you know, you get into the BC and the Stony Brooks. I mean, those pitching staffs are great. You know, those are ACC pitchers. So we got to do our part to figure out how do we adjust our hitting. And, you know, it's a matter of just having quality at bats and getting good strikes. I think we need to get extended on a few more balls and stop trying to, you know, hit so much with diving forward and staying in our legs and actually just throwing our barrel. But we'll get there. You know what? I think it's going to be a good week. We obviously have, you know, a few days off now, which would be nice. Reset, let their bodies heal up a little bit. And then we'll get back to grinding next week.
Congrats, Nicole, on the doubleheader sweep. You had 5 RBIs today, and you've been really hitting the ball well all week. What's been the key to your success this week?
I think just keeping it simple. I think as a team, we're trying to have good at-bats every time and see strikes and hit strikes. I think coach always says see ball, hit ball, and that's as simple as it is. And I think that's what we're trying to do here.
Right. And in terms of keeping it simple, you've been certainly showing a little more power this year. Is there a reason for that, or is it just kind of working out that way so far?
That's a good question. I think that, you know, we all been working really hard. We're always known as a very scrappy team, but I think like we all do have a lot of power throughout the lineup. And I think it's been coming through lately, and that's a great thing. So I think a little bit of both maybe.
Right. Well, and speaking of power, I mean, now five Terriers with a home run this season. I mean, do y'all feed off that energy from each other when another teammate like Ali Boas hit her first homer today? How much does that help other teammates when each person's hitting a homer?
Oh, absolutely. I think hitting is always contagious, and that energy is kind of contagious. Ali B did an incredible job today, starting us off with that home run and then coming up with a great double. But absolutely, I think that is incredibly contagious for our team. And that's something that we love to see and love to keep going on.
And then you continue to see, you've been catching it and playing at first, but watching Ali Dubois continue to dominate in the circle. I mean, what do you see from her when you're on the field?
Oh, Ali is incredible. She's maybe the greatest pitcher I've ever caught. She, the control that Ali has, the movement that Ali has, she owns everything. Every pitch, she's got a plethora of pitches that she can throw in any moment. And any time that she has the ball in her hand, I feel so confident that she's going to be able to make something happen for us. So it's so incredible to see her work. She gets better and better every time that I get to see her throw. So that's something really awesome.
Right. And then it's harder, sometimes hard to remember, but it's been over a year since y'all got to play. What has this week, just from that perspective, being able to play with your teammates, what has that experience been like this week?
Oh, it means the world. I mean, I think that there's so much craziness happening all over the place right now. And the fact that we get to come do the thing that we love every day and be with people that we love and be with the team. I mean, every day that we get to practice, it's a couple hours that we get to hang out with like some of my closest friends. So I think that it's been incredible for us. I think that we're just so grateful. We say, take it one day at a time, one game at a time, because, you know, we never know what's going to happen in the future, but we're enjoying every single moment that we get.
Right. And then from your perspective, the team is 7-1. I mean, where do you think the team's mindset is right now? I mean, what are the next steps you think the team needs to make?
Yeah, absolutely. I think that there's little things that we can sharpen up on. I think little base running things. I think that little hitting things, timely hitting, good at bats. I think that we just want to work on the small things that maybe we got to see a little bit more of this weekend that we didn't necessarily see versus Providence or this week. But yeah, there's just a couple of little things that we want to work on. I think the offensive mindset's going to be huge for us. I think working all of our pitchers in and getting them a couple of innings each and getting them comfortable is going to be really awesome. But I think we just want to step up our game a little bit and get ready for BC and Stony Brook for sure.
Right. Well, congrats again, Nicole, and thanks for joining me.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Scotty.